Hi, I just want to welcome you to my Periscope as I speak to you today about excellence in the supernatural, that being excellent in the realm of the supernatural, which all of us as believers in Jesus are called to be. Well, guess where it starts? It begins with intercession, not just ordinary intercession, but the spirit of intercession. And I'm talking about the Holy Spirit. Now, while you are jumping on board and sharing this with your followers, I'm going to actually share with you a testimony that came in response to my book, Seeing the Supernatural. I hope you have your copy, Seeing the Supernatural and the Intercessor's Handbook. But this one came in, and it's just an unusual testimony. I mean, somebody just took it full throttle, full force. This testimony that came out of my book, Seeing the Supernatural. And this person says, a year ago, I came to a conference at Harvest Christian Center. I bought your book, Seeing the Supernatural, and we had a renter in one of our, we'll just say ocean units, that had taken over a storage shed that wasn't hers. And she had a barking dog, not in a rental agreement, an abandoned car parked in the property, and was continually late paying her rent. After reading the book, Seeing the Supernatural, the Holy Spirit showed me that this person had all of the elements described that hold back the gospel of Jesus Christ, not to mention our financial blessings. Interesting, because there's a chapter in there that talks about how to discern territorial spirits, and it gives you, you know, descriptions and lists, and, you know, it's not all of the territorial spirits we deal with, but I think I put in there like the top four, top five that you will typically deal with, and just kind of gave a rundown on that. And so this person made note that she was having problems with a renter, that actually it was more spiritual than she recognized, and she didn't recognize the spiritual dimensions to it until she actually read the book, Seeing the Supernatural. So anyway, this is what she said. She said, I hired a friend who lived in the area to be an intercessor. Okay, this person is amazing. They're like, they actually hired a prayer person. They fired their management people, and they began to drive monthly to their ocean, their ocean property, her and her husband, and they began to not just evict the renter, they evicted the territorial spirits that were, you know, misusing or using this renter to create problems with them. And they begin to evict the five spirits that Jennifer described in Seeing the Supernatural. They reanointed the property. You know, they committed it to Jesus. They committed it to the Holy Spirit. They staked the property. Basically, we're, you know, saying that this property belongs to Jesus. And each month, they gave a deadline to the bad renter to give up the area she had violated with the help of a new management company. Then they delivered their 60-day notice to vacate, and this person had to obey. And now what's happened is the new manager's been able to raise the rent. They've finally been able to create financial profit on this property. And they are breaking even, getting profit on this property when they didn't have one before. And this happened because they read the book, Seeing the Supernatural, and they realized that their natural problem wasn't a natural problem. It was a spiritual problem. Okay, so anyway, I want to encourage you, get the book, Seeing the Supernatural. Get the book, Intercessor's Handbook. They will help you see into the spiritual realm. They will help you navigate the spiritual realm. It's biblically based. It's road tested. Okay, nothing there is theory. It's actually road tested, and it will really help you in any walk of life that you are in. I do want to let you know that I do have a mentorship, that an online mentorship that's starting this month in just a couple weeks, and I put the web address in the title line there. I'd love for you to join me because I believe in excellence in the supernatural. If you're a Christian, you are supernatural, okay? Let's not give the supernatural over to New Agers, pagans, other religions, other occultic religions. You know, God who created this earth and created you and I, you know, he started everything that's supernatural. He's a supernatural God. And for us to not walk in excellence, for us to not know and understand the spiritual realm, not know it biblically and not actually walk in it, you know, we're really shortchanging ourselves. I mean, this testimony proves it right here. This person, they corrected a financial problem because they understood the spiritual realm. Okay. And so anyway, I just want to share that with you. I do have this mentorship coming up. I did put the web address in the title line. I'd love to see you join me. It's from November to May, and join in. Okay, so today what I want to talk about is, you know, again, walking in excellence in the supernatural, it all begins with intercession. It all begins with prayer. And not just an ordinary intercession, it's actually partnership with the Holy Spirit. And I want to read to you out of Romans chapter 8, verse 26. And this is out of the Passion Translation. I just like what it says here. It says, in a similar way, the Holy Spirit takes hold of us. I love that. He'll take hold of you in our human frailty to empower us in our weakness. For example, at times we don't even know how to pray or even know the best things to ask for. Interesting. He wants you to pray the best things. He wants you to ask for the best things. But the Holy Spirit rises up within us to super intercede on our behalf, pleading to God with emotional sighs too deep for words. Now, really quick, I'm going to share this on my Twitter before I forget. So let me do that real quick. No, that's not what I meant to do here. Give me a second here. Let's see, Twitter, there we go. We got it. Okay, now we shared it on our Twitter. Okay, so the Holy Spirit will take hold of you because he wants you to pray the best things. He wants you to ask for the best things. And a lot of times we don't even know what the best things are. A lot of times we shortchange ourselves. You know, again, excellence in the supernatural is about knowing that there is a higher way to walk. There is a better way to walk, and it is a supernatural lifestyle. It's a supernatural dimension, and that God wants you to have the best because you know, he's the king and you're his kids. And so he wants you to understand this, but it all begins with prayer. So if you're going to walk in excellence in the supernatural, you have to have a prayer life. That's where it all starts. And sometimes we get going and, you know, we start getting promoted and we start seeing the blessing of God come in our lives. And then a new busyness and a new managing begins to happen in our lives. And we start to forsake prayer and we let go of prayer. We let go of intercession, forgetting where it all started. I don't know about you, but I started with nothing, okay? And all I knew was to pray. That's all I knew to do was to pray. And I've seen my life evolve because I've learned to let the Holy Spirit pray through me, you know. And I'm a person who believes in preaching the gospel in the nations. I'm a person who believes in high level intercession. I believe the Church of Jesus Christ needs to be healthy and thriving and supernatural, you know. But all of that begins in prayer. All of that has an individual responsibility as well as a corporate responsibility. And what I've also learned is that when he is doing something new, that the spirit of prayer will come upon you and you will actually feel a stirring to intercession. That's the Holy Spirit stirring you up and saying, it's time to pray. Not like you did yesterday. It's time to pray in a new way because something new is happening. You might not even have words for it. You might just find yourself praying in your prayer language. You might find yourself groaning in the spirit. You might find yourself in what's called travailing prayer. That's a prayer of the Holy Spirit that you can't make it up, but he will actually birth something through you and actually feel like a birthing. It can come in different strengths, from a more lighter version of it to a really deep and heavy version of it. I've experienced all sorts of different levels of that. And then also understand that, you know, prayer is a supernatural act. You know, it's not a natural act. It's not a ritual. It's not, just words that we say to the air. Prayer is a dialogue between you and the Holy Spirit that actually produces something, that actually creates something, okay, that actually prophesies something. There is a prayer that prophesies, and it is called prophetic intercession, but that comes out of praying in partnership with the Holy Spirit and giving birth to the next thing and the new thing. And so you know, prayer is a supernatural act. A lot of us don't even recognize that it's supernatural. This is why every religion prays, because they recognize the supernatural dimensions of prayer. Now they're praying, these other religions are praying to a demon, okay, and they're actually empowering a demon through their intercession, okay. How much more the Christian, the believer in Jesus, when they pray to the King of Kings, you know, to Jesus, who is the name above all names, okay, it flatlines anything that's demonic, any demonic prayer, any demonic hex spell or curse that's being, released in the earth. But that means we as Christians need to understand the role of intercession in our lives. It needs to move like a river. It does move like a river. We need to partner with the Holy Spirit, recognize his call to prayer. Prayer is always the first thing. Prayer is the first, is our first priority. And if you always remember that, no matter how busy you get, no matter how wealthy you get, no matter how how many ministry engagements you get. If you always put prayer in the first place, you will always walk excellently in the supernatural. Thank you so much for joining me on my Periscope today. I look forward to seeing you on the mentorship. Again, that website to register is right there in the title line. And I'm doing this mentorship because I'm passionate about the supernatural, and I'm passionate about seeing the body of Christ equipped and trained in those realms, because this is where we really live to win, and we see the kingdom of God advance in our lives, through our lives, and in the earth. Thank you so much.